Alright, so now that my gas tank swap's completed, I went ahead and decided to do my power steering. It was it's always been mad at me, squealing and everything, and it finally started leaking. And I took it apart, still got that honey oil, that steering oil, that's the stock stuff, so it's been running 191,000 I have on this rig now. 16th, here, hold on. Yeah, C-Dan back in the day said this was 13/16ths. It might be on the earlier models, but mine's a 97. So I'd say from 95 to 97, at least I'd be pretty sure that this is, it's actually a 24. Here, let's see. Can barely read it. Anyways, that's a 24. Or a 15/16ths right there. This is the bad boy that's hard to get to. This is the banjo that goes on top of this. Alright, and then they said something about this being a 12 point. It is. It needs to be a 12 point. This is my next thing I gotta do is get this thing off and I get my tread depth. It was mentioned to make sure that you get the same depth. So I found some wrenches that were pretty right on. I got this one. It's 5/8. This is another 5/8. I'm all over the place with my video here. 5/8. It's a little bit loose right here. Otherwise, you get some tapping sounds or some whining or something if you don't get this gear in there just right. Alright, so I'll post some more vids and stuff, so hold on. Another thing I found helpful was just take the battery out. It makes it so much easier to get your arm in here and stuff. And another thing that, I don't have my light on here. Hold on. I'm such a professional videoer. Another thing is, you can be able to get through here a lot easier too. If you take that mud flap off. You got, when you replace the high-end pressure hose right here, you need a 17 millimeter flare wrench. Alright, so don't ask me why I do these videos. Maybe it's just for pure entertainment. I don't know. I might be the laughing stock here. So, I say you can get this nut off here with a good pair of gloves and a wrench. So, let's see. Next, gotta get the gear pulled. Hold on. There we go. Obviously, I haven't done this before, huh? Alright, I get now what they were talking about on the depth. You have to measure that. Is because this thing's on a wedged incline, it doesn't have a lip that stops. And so, when you transfer this
those things, pins. And all that.
Alright, here are the parts that they, I was told I need to get. Here's the banjo. The stalkers are copper. This has some pretty cool double banjo thing going on there. An O-ring. And this orange one. And first time opening this. Had it since February. No. That's a long time. Donut. Alright, here's the new pump. Pretty. You know, some people, this is your just your basic stuff, but no, man, I enjoy this journey. Okay, so one thing I realize just right now is this 24 millimeter or this 15/16. No wonder I had such problems taking that off. I actually ended up using a crescent because I just couldn't figure it out. They said it was 13/16 and I was just rolling around, and it turns out that 15/16 might just not work for you. Might have to throw a crescent on there. All right, we're gonna put this bad boy, this pin and this gear in next. It is down here. Let me see if I can get that in there. And it meshes with that gear right there. Also with this gasket, this O-ring orange gasket here, they're saying you gotta be really careful when you stab that bad boy back in there that this gasket does not get compromised. Otherwise you have a leaky. All right. Okay. It's time. Is it gonna start? Do I have fuel? Am I gonna have leaks? Am I gonna have a diesel sound coming from my power steering pump? I don't know. Let's find out. Woo! She started. It's a little bit of a knocking sound. Alright. So, what I did different here is I went ahead and took the opportunity to put a cooler in. I've had this thing probably a year now. Maybe. And I just went ahead and took some 3/8 tranny line. Ran it up to the normal spots. And I decided to go ahead and put it that there instead of in the normal spot people put it. I think it's right here. I'll put it there if a winch, if I have to put a winch in or if the winch is in the way, and I'll just put that in the other spot. But other than that, this is working. Now I get to go to the gas station. I only got 2 gallons of gas in my 80 undercover Lexus 450. Can't see very good. Anyways, take care.